Well, good morning, class. Today I'm going to give you a brief overview of exercise 1D. Now, when you log into Blackboard, you'll see a few different files available to you for exercise 1D. Now, complete instructions are located in your textbook, so be sure to use it. But I'm just going to go over a few things to kind of help you out with exercise 1D so you won't be totally confused. As you can see, there are two different appendix files that you can choose from. You can pick one or the other, but one of the most important critical parts to this assignment is I do not want multiple students picking the same data file. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the first file and let that open. And as you can see, it's taken my computer a little bit of time to load. Sorry about the delay. Should have pulled that up ahead of time. Okay, here we go. Now, as you can see, in your book, you're going to see these different exercise SPSS data files. Now, each page is a different one. That was number two, here's number three, here's number four. And if you notice, they all have rows and columns. These are examples of SPSS output files, output data files. So you need to pick one of these, not all of them, just pick one that you have a preference for so that you can complete exercise 1D. Okay, so let me close that out. And once again, you're just gonna pick from either of these files and you're gonna select one of the SPSS data output files to work with. All right, now let me switch over to the book. Let me bring that here. Exercise 1D consists of creating APA style tables. Okay, like I said, you want to pick out one of the SPSS data files to use. And let's see. Make sure you watch the online videos, parts one and parts two of SPSS data analysis so you'll understand what I'm referring to. And this is essentially what an APA style table looks like. In your book, you'll find a diagram which helps you to understand exactly which segment of the data charts that you're working with. Segment A is, of course, the title. Segment B is, of course, the column spanner, and so on and so forth. Now, this is what your final paper should look like. It should be an APA style title page. And once again, all of this is contained in your book. And I'm not going to read through all of this because I know you can do that on your own. And here's an example for exercise 1D of what you're going to turn in. Your paper for exercise 1D will consist of no more than three pages. Page one is your cover page. Okay, it's that easy. Page two is your bivariate table based on the SPSS data file output that you selected. And that's your bivariate table. And then you're also going to include a multivariate table. Now, let's see, where did you get these numbers? Where did these numbers come from? And I don't want you to panic when you see a whole bunch of numbers and you're like, oh my gosh, I don't understand this. Yeah, you'll see how really easy it is. It is that easy. Okay. Keeping in mind, when you look in the book, I have, you know, kind of made a diagram, drawn it out for you, made it a little bit easier. Your dependent variable is always going to be your row variables. And in this case, when we're looking at attitudes about drinking age, your rows are going to be the attitudes, whether people agreed, had no opinion, or disagreed. And the independent variable in this case is going to be the age. And the control variable. And control variable, this is really important because this is what you're going to need to know for your multivariate table. Okay, so if we look at these numbers, now let's go back a little bit. Say, for example, For those under 30, 76.9% of the respondents agreed. Okay, so let's look in our bivariate table up here. Ta-da! And that's where you get to 76.9%. Under 30 agreed. And this is so easy. And you just continue on with that based on the rows and the columns, the information, the data that was contained in your SPS output. Once again, you have your SPS output, and you don't have to do any math at all for this. All you need to do is be able to read and interpret the SPS crosstab output and place it in the correct format, which in this case is an APA style table. It's just that easy. Okay, so I think I've reviewed enough for now. And if you have additional questions, do not hesitate to come by my office or email me and ask questions as you need help. I would hate to see you be totally lost. So just make sure if you have questions, please ask. Thanks for watching and have a great day.